You know, as an author, I love to use my bookshelves to show off my books, and for the first time ever, I think I'm going to redecorate by doing them by color, so I'm pretty excited for this one. I actually have not redesigned these shelves since I moved into this house months ago, and it is way overdue, so let's go ahead. We're going to dive in, and we're going to actually recreate my bookshelves today. So typically when I'm decorating my bookshelves, I'm doing it specifically to show off my books. I'm an author, I have over 24 published best-selling books, and I like to make sure that my covers are face out so that people can check those out. I use these when I am live streaming, when I'm doing my videos, like my bookshelves are my background all the time, specifically for marketing purposes, both in my author life and in my social media education life. And so I make sure that I know exactly what I'm doing and where I'm positioning myself to show off books behind me as I am talking on my camera. So I typically put my books face out. I will put books next to them stacked so the spines are facing out. Occasionally I will put other popular books to catch people's eye. So, you know, things like the Selection series or the Hunger Games or Divergent, I'll put those face out because those are the things that my readers gravitate toward. And if they see books that they know, they'll also notice my books if they're new to me and they don't actually know my novels yet. So I typically put my books face out. I'll put other books' spines out next to it. And I also like to stack them like this as opposed to like this so that you have some texture and some interest in the bookshelf, so it's not all just like stack of books and kind of boring. So I make sure that I add depth and visual appeal that way, and then I add in like trinkets. I typically do like a lot of greenery. So you guys know I love my succulents, I love my flowers. I'm terribly allergic to flowers, so mine are all fake. My succulents are also fake because I kind of beat them up a little bit because I'm using them in my photos all the time. So when I'm doing my lifestyle photography, my Bookstagram photos, I am using those in there, and I don't want to, you know, jostle the plants too much, and I don't want to dump the dirt and like whatever. So mine are all from craft stores. I love going to places like Michael's, and Target has some really great ones, and Hobby Lobby. So there's a lot of really cool places that I can get my succulents, and you guys send me succulents sometimes as well. Y'all are the best. I love it when you guys send me little succulents to go on my bookshelves, and I always make sure I display them for you. And sometimes you send me other things as well. I've had people who have sent me like Pop Funkos and just like different teapots and flowery things and just trinkets to put up on the bookshelves as well. And a lot of authors also send me their books to be featured on the bookshelves too. So I get a lot of really cool stuff that people are sending into me to then display on my shelves. Now, I typically, when I'm doing this, I like to go around my greenery. So I'll put the books up first. I'll kind of like stack them the way that I want. I'll organize them so they look all pretty. I make sure I know where I'm going to be standing, so I have different places along my shelves, because I've got the 5-stack here that we're going to be redesigning today, the 3-stack over there, and then I've got some others around. And I know in the different places that I'm going to be standing where I have to like not put it where my head is going to be. So I kind of figure that out first and figure out how I'm going to make them propped up. Sometimes I actually, I'll like put mugs behind the books to make sure that they stand up straight, or I'll put something in front of it if it's a paperback so it doesn't warp outward. Because fun fact, books definitely warp outward as you have them sitting there. I'm like looking for, let me show you right here. So this one is definitely warping out, but you can see how I've got stuff in front of it to kind of like help it to make sure that it doesn't do that, whereas like hardcover books are not going to warp. So I'm always really careful as I'm doing those kind of things to make sure that I'm taking care of my books, and when I start to see something work, I'll swap it out for something else so that I don't really bend the books too much. I'll flatten them out by putting other books on top of them, whatever I have to do. And so I put the books there, I stack them up, and then we're just gonna take a little tour is what we're gonna do today, I guess. And then I put in my greenery. So the first thing I do is I have my greenery hanging down. In my old shelves in the old house, I used to have like stuff up here that kind of tied it all together, and I really miss that. I don't have that here, I didn't do that here. But I might do it in my new setup, so we'll see what happens today. And then I put in like some gap space, so we've got like lots of books, a few books. Spaces here. We've got some of the white in the background. I always make sure that I kind of like have space for things. I just popped this in there the other day. These are my headbands for my Reader Convo series over on TikTok, where she was always wearing those headbands. I couldn't function anymore with the lack of space for my headbands, so I bought one of those containery things from Amazon, and I put them in there. Definitely just broke that. And I put in like little trinkets, so I've got like the little perfume atomizers and teacups and my steampunk type stuff. And I make sure I go all the way up as high as I can. On the stack over there, the three stack, I have like flowers and florals and all these really cool stuff up there, but I kind of like that. And then I always try to put like little brassy things or golden things, things that are sparkly and shiny, so that I can have that color and that texture in them. And I just do like some that are very, very colorful and some that, you know, have a little more space. So we've got things with space here, and then we've got things that are a little more intense with the things that I've got going on here. And I'm missing a whole section of my books because I just did a photos series with a bunch of pink ones, and they're sitting over on my fireplace right now. So this is kind of what I've got now. So let me just kind of show you. We'll just take a little tour here. I just got my pink yesterday. I'm so excited about this. So we've got all these, and this is kind of what I had done with it. And I definitely like, I love my little lemons, like my pop of color, and I've got different succulents that I just place everywhere. Down on the bottom here, these are all books that I had for conventions, but all the conventions got canceled, so I still have them to sell to you guys. And I, over here, I hadn't been using this corner until I got this chair like 2 weeks ago. And so these are all like older books, they're more like classic books. That's gonna change because now I'm using this corner very dramatically. So there's gonna be a lot more of my books right along here. And then I typically focus right in this general area. I stand here, I stand here, I stand here. So this is kind of the careful with my head while I'm filming kind of look to it. And then we've got, you know, stuff over here. We've got mugs and we've got little accessories and just like cute little things. And so now I'm just gonna fill it out, and I think I'm gonna go very much by color for this. So for the first time ever, I'm actually gonna try to do like a purple shelf and a red shelf and a yellow shelf. And it's not gonna work great because I don't have enough books in specific colors. I'm gonna break up my series. That's gonna be a trick and a half. I'm gonna have like, you know, some reds, some whites. I don't have a ton of things, I don't think. But we're gonna find out, we're gonna see how it works, and we're gonna put this all together. So step number one here is, for sure, to tear everything down, organize my books into groups of colors, and then we're gonna start putting them back up. If you love me, let me hear you say my name. Okay, I've taken all of the swag down. I've just got the blank shelves with all the books now, which means it's time to take the books down. We are going to be putting all these fabulous things right here. All that, all my swag, all my stuff. All of that's gonna go back on the shelves momentarily, but for now, I'm gonna take all the books down. Let's go. Okay, Joe Diane, let's take a look at what we've got. I started over in this corner, with a white shelf. We do have another white shelf down below. We'll get to that in a minute. We've got some pinks. And yes, I do have this really cute little flamingo succulent. I got that from Target. It's one of my favorite things. I've got a whale over on the other side in blue. We've got my, what I'm now calling my mermaid shelf, but it's my blue tone shelf. And my reds, I love how the reds turned out. Like, how dang pretty is that? How pretty is that? We've got like our seafoamy greens and blues and teal colors with the princesses and the mermaids. So I guess it's like a two-part mermaid type deal here. We've got my golds and my yellows and my oranges. Obviously, we've got lots of golden in here, but we've also got Cyndrel as well. We've got some purples going on over here. Lots of purple books in my collection. We've also got the darker tone books, so you can see the original golden covers here. We've got all my original covers up here as well. We've got some cool stuff going on up at the top here as well. I didn't have enough rainbows for all the shelves, so some of them are mixed, but we've got more of like the pinks and the purples here. And then we jump down to like the blues and again kind of with like those teal and green colors with the succulents and the cute little perfume bottle. Like, how dang cute is that? This one I love. I just got this, the hashtag, for like $2.49 at TJ Maxx, one of those stores. It was on sale. And so I've got my like navy books here. And then we come down to the other shelf that's got all the white base stuff with lots of like cool succulents and pink tones. It's so funny because what I've noticed is with white books, they tend to be paired with pink in my collections. Down, if we go down to the bottom, these books right here are all the ones I have left over from the conventions that didn't happen last year. So you guys can buy those before I have to restock. Up here, we come to my green shelf. So we've got, of course, Mulan Dragon Shifter right by Insurgent and some other really cool things. There's some friends of mine mixed in here as well. We've got another red shelf, which I love, with all the pretty things and the circus books and all the good stuff. We've got our darker blues with my really pretty teacup, which, look at this. I just put little, like, those I got from, I want to say, well, part of it fell off of something, but the other part was from Hobby Lobby, just in like a bag of like broken things, and I love it. And so we've got kind of like our dark tones, like purples and navies. And then we've got over here, we've just kind of got like the mismatched rainbowy type things. But like, how cute is that? It turned out so good, didn't it? So this is kind of like right here, mostly, is the area that I film. And then when I'm on the ground down here, I film down in this section. So these are kind of more of like things that will be in my photos and in my videos more so than this side down here. But like, how cool does all that look? We've got the steampunk goggles up there and books and florally things and all sorts of cool stuff. So as you can see, there's a bit of an outfit change. This actually took more than the day that I had allotted for this because when I started to create my shelves, it got a little crazy. It didn't really work the way that I thought it was going to, and I actually thought until the very last possible second that I was gonna have to tear everything down and start again and not do the bi-color shelves because I didn't think I had enough books to properly fill out the space. And like I said, that last stack down there is not color coordinated just because most of the books that I have acquired over the years have dark or black colored spines. And that just doesn't work with the rainbow vibes. So you can see I've got a lot of like really dark shelves, and that's just because those are the types of books that I have apparently acquired over the years, which is why I personally try really, really hard to make sure that my book covers have really attractive spines and back covers so y'all have something to show out on social media as well. So I did manage to pull everything together. I actually did half of it and then I let it sit overnight and I jumped back in and I finished this up and then I added in all the decor. I kind of like went with like different decorations for the different colors, so you can kind of see how like clearly I put in yellow things on the yellow shelves and kind of orangey tones, and I went with like greens for the shelves down here and purpleys and pinks for the shelves up here. So there's lots of different, you know, accessories that I've put with my bookshelf to kind of make these pop and make these in the different colors, but I'm pretty pleased with how it turned out. I'm gonna be filming some and doing some different photos and things in front of these shelves before I mix it up again. And when I do that, I'm probably gonna go back to displaying the books so that they look pretty, not just with their colors, but I really like this option because it did in fact allow me to display a lot of my books. Not all of them, but it did allow me to display a lot of them without taking up too much. I don't necessarily love that I don't have them stacked the way I did before. Most of these are pretty much up and down, like standing the way that the books are supposed to on a shelf, but I like to like layer them and put them at different levels, and I didn't do that with this because I didn't know how they would all fit in. So I have it a little bit, but not nearly as much as I want. So this will last for a little bit. I don't know how long, but for a little while, I will be leaving it with the rainbows. Let me know down below, what should I do for my next bookshelf redesign? Should I do it in a special way? Should I do more like color-based things? Give me your ideas, give me your thoughts down in the comments below, and let me know, are you loving on these shelves? Don't be rude or don't be mean, but like, are you loving on these shelves? If you are, let me know down below. And if not, give me some suggestions for what I can do next time, because these will probably last about a couple of weeks to maybe a month, and I will be revamping this yet again so we can do some cool new things with the social media because I love doing my shelves on social media. Y'all know that with my TikToks and my Instagrams and all the fun things. So let me know down in the comments below, what do you want to see from me next? And make sure you hit the subscribe and notification bell, because in our next vlog, we're going to be taking even more of a look behind the scenes at what an author's life really is. And I've got some cool new ideas for the YouTube channel here that you don't want to miss out on. So hit the subscribe and notification bell, and I will see you again in the next author vlog. Bye. This one's my favorite. It's purple. It goes in my outfit. It's my favorite color. I love all the purpley colors. Look at this. I've got a whole pink corner here. We've got like the whites and the pinks. We've got the sparkly background. We've got the chair and the fun pillow. Like, it's pink and I love it.